Hello everyone. Today I would like to show you how we can set up our workspace in a way that you can deploy a test environment. You can have connectivity with the environment from your local machine, so you can access by SSH to the different machines, to the server, a proxy, different clients, to the controller. Then we will install an ID like RubyMine that has support for Cucumber, so it can parse the Cucumber features and you can develop your test there. Then we will proceed to check out the uni project, the uni repository, and we will navigate through the source code of the test using the ID. Having that, we will try a simple feature, just few steps. So I will show you how you can develop using RubyMine in that case, a feature and having a browser on another screen, so you can see the different actions that your test framework is doing on the browser. You will be able to add breakpoints wherever you want, to inspect some variables. Okay, so now let's start deploying the test environment. Okay, first of all, we need to go to the SUSE repository in a uni project. There you will have all the documentation about how to install it. In my case, I install it using the tumbleweed repository. Then you need to install that Terraform provider, libert, git core, and you will check out SUSE project somewhere. Okay, and then there is some other configurations, like we will deploy using libert backend, so yeah, we'll run it in our local. The main TF we will use to deploy will be something like that. This is a unit test environment that we will set up in local using our local hypervisor. Remember, you need to configure some SSH user and password and GitHub user and the email. And then we will have set up a controller, server, proxy, and three SLES clients for traditional client, salt minion, and SSH minion. Okay. So we go to a console, make it bigger. I have this space here, maybe too big. Okay. In my case, I have a SUSE form checkout here, but I have a link here, and then salt, which is in fact inside SUSE form. But we need to have it also outside. Okay, then I have my main TF, as I show you. I'm gonna just clean previous Terraform states, because we will run a clean on a clean environment. You see, I have my virtual manager. I have set up disk for it. You can have it in the default, and then yes, have to set up the default network, and well, it will be connected to Quemu system, which is your local. That's all for now. So we do Terraform init. Okay, all clear, and then we do Terraform apply. You do that with that sudo, I will ask you, and then you can press yes to start synchronizing everything, deploying everything. This is gonna take long time, at least. Well, it depends on your machine, but at least I would say 20 minutes. Because it will also download the images, which is what it's doing right now, from internet to your disk. So that's gonna take a bit of time. I'm gonna pause the video here and just come back when it's finished. Okay, it should go all well. So I wanna just show you the last lines of the result. Okay, so I just restarted the Terraform apply again, because as you can see, sometimes you need to just monitor a bit it, because it's taking a lot of time to download the images, that sometimes we have a timeout. Currently it seems working. I deployed it again and it's on it. It's on it. We will see. But you go to the virtual manager, you should start see some VMs there deployed. Okay, so the VMs are there. It's just working on configuring everything. Okay, go to the details. We'll see that we have a uyuni master private network. We also have some disk already created there. Okay, so still waiting a bit more. Okay, so now if we go to our hypervisor, we'll see that we have already all the VMs, including the controller. And we can check if we can do a bahi browse resolve, n uyuni master server dot tf dot local, and it works. This sometimes will give you IPv6, sometimes IPv4. Well, now it's just giving IPv6, but it's kind of 50-50. And if we do, I think it's like that, the command. See, we can see all the different VMs from Abahi, and we have SSH access to all of them. Okay, so from here we can start to work on the controller. If we go to the controller like that, local, we have directly access here, and we can go to the spacebook folder. Don't be worried, because this in fact is uyuni. Okay, it's just that we are giving this name for compatibility with the CI commands we have. So from here we have the folder, the test suite folder, and we are ready to start our test. We will continue in the next video. So let's start now by running in our controller the first features that we have, the first cucumber features that we have, that will create an organization, create an admin user. repo sync products and prepare the bootstrap of client. So all the basic needs, the essential needs that we need before we can start developing our new feature and debugging it. Okay, so for that we have different commands that we can use. As you can see, we have a rake file, and on that rake file we do rake t to see all the different options. You will see we have these cucumber options here. For instance, cucumber core. This is the second part. Are related to the YAML files that we have contained in runsets. Okay, and if we take a look to the core YAML file, we'll see we have these cucumber features, and we plan to run these first cucumber features, so we have the environment prepared. We will have these ones, and also we'll run the repo sync, and they need clients. Okay, well, and we will do also a sanity check, which is here. For that, we can use these rake commands and go one by one, or we can also have an util, which is, let me just show you the code. This is in user bin run test suite. Okay, this command has a different, has this function stage that we'll call what we were saying, the rake cucumber. So we have this option essential that if we run it, it will run all what we need. So let's just do run test suite essential. Let's make it. Okay, I think you will be able to see like that. This will take some time. I would say at least 30 minutes. Okay, so it's time to take a coffee and wait for it. What I will do is pause the video at that moment so you can watch the end. We'll just go directly to the end of that video. Okay. Now we are almost at the end. We are already set up the proxy, and now we are registering the three clients, the traditional client, the minion, and SSH minion. We can go, meanwhile this is doing, to the server portal, going to this address, uyuni-master server tf local. We should have access, yes. And then the user and password is admin, which is set up in our cucumber features, if you look there. And there, if we go to the systems list, we have already the proxy set up as a proxy. With for now, we have the traditional client already registered, and yes, we will have the rest soon. We go to proxy, we'll see we have this proxy here. Proxy set up as a salt minion. We also have in the salt keys the key of the proxy, and we'll soon have a salt minion also registered. We'll see it here soon, because if we go to the test, we can see that at that moment what we are doing is bootstrapping using the proxy salt minion. Okay, let's just wait a bit so we can see it here. now the bootstrap is successful and the test is going inside the system overview of this minion to see if it's all good there. We will do the same manually. We just can go here to the browser, and in the system list you will see we have now the minion registered. We go inside to the overview page. You will see that still not ready because the product, for instance, is unknown. Yeah, it's missing some data, the channel subscribed. So if we go to events on the history, we can see that it already did the hardware list refresh and the apply states. So having the applied states, it should be enough. If we go again to the details, yes, now we have it ready. Okay. And yes, the last one will be the SSH minion. It will come soon also. At that moment, we're still checking if the minion is registered on the proxy. We can also check that. We'll go here to the minion, go to the connection. We should see that it's connected to the proxy, using the proxy. We are also subscribing SLE minion to a base channel. So if we go to details, now we have this base channel subscribed. Yes, I will pause again. Yes, come back when SSH minion is done. And done. We have everything test passed, and if we go to the browser, we'll see we have three clients and the proxy. SSH minion is here and it's ready also. So that's all for now, and we can close the controller at that point. Let's just check that from our local we have access to the server, for instance, by SSH using a root user. Yep, all good. This is because I prepared something that I will show you on the next video. And for now, let's stop here. Okay, so from that point, we have already set up an environment using SumaForm, which is really here. We have run our first cucumber test from the controller VM, so it's set up all our uni environment with all the different registered clients. And now we need to assure that we have a connectivity between our local machine and the VMs. So the idea is that the SSH connection can work without an user and password. So we'll use a SSH key. For that, what we can do is go to the controller, and inside the controller we'll have a public key and private key. We just need to copy them inside our local machine. I said it here, I copied and I changed the name, so I have it in that way. Just be sure that your permissions are correct, right? Are not to open. And then in the SSH config, you need to add a block like that where you filter by our tf.local domain. We will connect using root user, and here you pass the private key. So if we do SSH uyuni without root, just uyuni server, you can access directly. If we do the same with proxy, no problem. So all good from that point. Next point is to have installed RubyMine or some similar ID if you find another, but need to have a Cucumber support, because yeah, this is the idea of using an ID here. If not, you can also use Vim. I mean, so you go to browser and you write RubyMine, it will find this link. Okay, so you have a 30 days trial, or you can buy a license. What I did is I have a student account on a university, so having just an email will work. It will not check anything else, just the email. So you download it. You can download the toolbox app, so you can make it more like isolated from everything else, or you can download it directly. It will work for Linux, for Mac, for Windows. In that case, we are in SUSE Tumbleweed, but I also tried on Mac. And yes, there is no problem for our setting our project, because yes, we will just use gems, and the only special gems is two pens gems that we will need to do a manual step for building libraries from there. But it's all explained in the documentation of the project. We have it documented in, I will show you later the step to make it possible in case you want. So we have that this installed. Now we will check out uyuni repository. Uyuni repository, as you know, it's on uyuni project / uyuni here. In this repo, you can just check out this repo. Okay. Once you have it, I have it here on repos Barrios uyuni. You will have this this structure. The only thing we need to take care of now is the test suite folder. Okay. Here it will live. The test framework and the test that will run for uyuni. Okay, so in the features section, you have the step definitions, Cucumber step definitions. You have a support classes who run the different methods on the step definitions. And then, for instance, if we go to init clients, we have the dot feature files, the Cucumber feature files that have this special language, which is Gherkin language, that will be the way we design our test plan or test case. Okay, through different scenarios. So, having that, what we want to do is to open the test suite using our ID. Okay, we open RubyMine. Sorry, it will open now an open session. Let's close it. So first window you will have is this one. Okay. And then you go to open you go to where you have the testbit folder, not the uyuni repository, but directly to the testbit folder, and you click, it will open and import the project. Okay, with well, it will open first the README, but yes, you will see here the project with the structure. If we go to the settings of this project, you can go to the project structure and see that that was added as test folder. On the language sections, you need to set up your Ruby SDK. I'm gonna use, on that case, 2.7 and apply. Okay, and yeah, that is almost all that you need to touch, and the rest is just completely done automatically. And then if you go to the different folders we have, we can instead go to the Cucumber features. You will see it's supporting this format. Let's make it bigger. A second. Okay, I was wondering why I can't increase it with my normal options. Maybe as I set up a new RubyMine, something missing. Yeah, so change font size with control mouse. Yeah, sorry. Let's make it bigger. Okay. Maybe too much now, but yeah, it's fine. We can see here that we can see the different scenarios. You will be able to run this feature or run a concrete scenario. We can, if you click on control, jump from the step here to the step definition. Okay, as you see, we click it from here to here, and then from here we can see also that we have a node. This is a lambda object, it's a wrapper of two pens. Here is a method run. If we click on this with clicking on the control button also, we have different implementation options. The first one is the one we want to go, which is feature support lambda. And that will go to the definition, the implementation of the run method. Okay? So you can do that with whatever option you want. You will you can go directly, for instance, to this global variable. If you click here, you go to the definition of this global variable. If you click here and you tap on Find Usage, you can very easily see all the different usage of this product variable in the different Ruby files and the different options. You can, for instance, let me try something. Constants. Yeah. So, in theory, this is also showing warnings. Well, if you just put your mouse on top of a method, it will explain you what this method does. If, for instance, we remove a freeze from this constant, it should show a warning at some moment, if I'm not wrong. Problems? Maybe? maybe I still need to configure something. But yeah, to show you. Warnings also. Let's try to go somewhere else. CH. Yeah. So for now, it's showing the typos. Words that it thinks are typos, but are not, in fact. But yeah, it do other kind of inspections, in fact. It also read gem files. It read rake files. So it format everything, and you can work with any of these files from the Ruby ecosystem. Okay, even RuboCop. Okay, you can have a RuboCop format here. See, it's missing from the current project install. Okay, I see. So I was not having the warnings from RuboCop because it's missing the install the RuboCop. And re-enable it. I'm gonna click here. It will do all automatically for me. Searching for gems now. It's installing it. I don't know if you see it here. Should be good now. Okay. We'll go after to this other warning, but yeah, let's for now go again to the constants, because I wanted to show you the whole, we can have also warnings from RuboCop. So if we remove that, we should have now, yes, see, there is a warning that it says RuboCop freeze mutable object assigned to constants, and then you can just do fix and it will add the what is missing to fix this offense of mutable constant. Okay, we'll add automatically this freeze option, freeze method, and you have it fixed. Okay, you will see these kind of warnings everywhere. Maybe here, for instance, yeah, we can, if we maybe change something here, like changing this for parentheses. Yes, shows also another RuboCop which says that you need to use the brackets. You fix it. That's all. See, it's this is very powerful. And it takes into account your RuboCop file here, or your RuboCop to-do things, for all the things you want to filter. Okay, what else I can show you? Okay, from that point, you can start develop a new feature, in fact. But let's try to first have it configured, the environment. So you have all the gems installed in your system. As I was warning before, in case of the two pens gem, you might need to also install their RPMs coming from here. Okay, you go to this repository. You add the repository using zipper or whatever distro you are using, and you install all the two pens RPMs. Okay, once you have it, well, you can do that, or in case of Mac, you can check out this project and build and install manually. Once you have that, you will be able to run all the gems. So what we used to do, it's manually, it's go to a terminal. We have here a terminal also. And you write bundle install, and this will run everything. But you can do that. I will do that, in fact. Or you can do also that from tools, bundler, install. Okay, you click here and it will be the same, but I prefer to do from here because you will see the logs of the output more clear. Now tap. You see it's fetching gem metadata from Ruby gems where all the gems must be. Well, in that case, as I almost has all of them installed, you will have all these fetching and installing every of them. But once it's all done, you will have a bundle complete with all the gems there. Okay, you do, for instance, gem info to parents. You will have the information of this gem and where we have it. As you see, we are using Ruby 2.7 as I set up in the SDK on the app. So it's all good from that point. Next step. So we open the test suite, we navigate through the source code. You see that it's very easy. We can write a sample feature. Okay. We will just go to init clients, for instance, and we will just copy this and create a copy of that. Sample test. This, yeah, the idea is also handling all the Git options. So it's also, you have also an user of GitHub that you can configure, and if you click on add, we'll mark this for to be added to Git. Okay. So here you have all the different branches that we have, and if we do now git status, you will see this automatically added this file. We don't want to add, I will not add, but yeah, just for showing you that. Okay, so from that point we have this feature. I will remove some content and just let it something very, very minimal. Like, for instance, yes, let's remove all of that. My sample test, my sample feature. Here we have a scenario. In this scenario, what I will do is check the SLE minion product. Okay. To that, first I will go to the SLE minion. Okay. Let's do something first. Let's do this also, just in case. Given I'm right, and I go to SLE minion. This SLE minion we have here is set up from here, from the get systems. You get the system because we have all the list of clients in the environment, in the tuple, sorry. Tuples in it, and the minion which is here is a variable of the environment which is set up in the controller, and getting this value from the minion okay, you can initialize the node of the minion which will be used in our case here. Okay, so then what I want to do is, now that I'm on the view, I when I follow. So let's open now the server. This is the server. First thing we want to do is go to the minion. We go to the overview of the minion. And now what I want to do is check that this name is on the page. So we'll copy that. I see. I should. See. This one. I should see a string text. Okay. Then I paste here the text I want to see. In fact, this is given when then. So, given I'm authorized, when I'm on the system overview page, then I should see this product, this text on the page. Okay? It's a very easy feature. Here, used to also add some text like I'm as a user I want to be sure that my minion is a SLE 15 SP1 or something like that. Yeah. So it's just an example. If you click here, you will go to the definition of this step. Okay. If you click here, you go to the other definition. As you could see, if I add something else, just adding an I. And you will see all the different options we have with I am or I call, and we have all the different options, or yeah, the something, yeah, all these definitions. If you click on one of them, it doesn't matter which one, for instance, this one, you click, it will autocomplete, and if you click there, you will see the step definition where it jumps. Okay, this is very useful, and you can develop very faster if you have these options. Okay, now that we have that, next step is how we connect this ID with our environment. To do that, you go to a controller, to the controller. You will see we have a file called, well, we have a, let me think how we can do that. Let's do just a head of bash rc. You will have this bash rc file, okay? This bash rc file will have a different exports of all the different minions. It will have also some kind of potential content that I can't show in this video, like the users and password for SEC and this kind of stuff. So what I will do now is copy what I need from here, from the batch RC, and show you in a different file. Okay, so wait a second, and you can just go to your bashers file and do the same. Okay, so I copied in my Sublime editor. Here are the different machines we will connect on and some other extra variables that I want to also add to our configuration. To make it work, we will remove these exports. And we will remove the quotes, the double quotes. Okay. Let's remove all of that. Once we have that, if we, well, let's copy all of that. And if we go to RubyMine, you can click here and modify run configuration. Okay, so it will open this window. This window have as a first step the feature file you want to run, then some runner options, the cucumber gem you want to use. In my case, I think it will go to 2.0. Then you have environment variables. Let's remove this one. We don't want to have this one. We have the project SDK. We can use another, but let's use what we set up already, the 2.7. And the environment variables, if you click here in this small button to edit, you can click then on paste, and it will automatically add all the different variables that we have from the controller in your system. Okay, in your configuration, sorry. So this is only for your configuration, it's not exported to your system. And you will need to set up that every time you run it. Okay, so once we have it, we will add a last option, which is debug. In fact, the what we put in the value doesn't matter, it just must exist. Okay, so now, as you can see, we have this option here, this configuration. Okay, so we are ready to run our feature, showing also a browser on the screen. The difference running on the controller and running here, adding this debug option, is that the with the debug option, we'll jump into this debug mode, and this debug mode will add, if you don't have the debug mode, you will have a headless in the Selenium WebDriver. If not, it will not be added. So let's close everything else, close other tabs. We only have that. We want to run that, but we want to run that with breakpoints, because we want to go one by one and see the things it's doing. So you can go here, and in your first step, add a breakpoint. You can also add breakpoints different places, like here, 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 and here. So we will stop everywhere. It's just to show you. On this version of RubyMine, for some reason, they break the support to add the breakpoints at the gherkin level. But yeah, I guess it will come back at some point. But yeah, you go inside, you can do it from the Ruby files. Okay, let's do something before that, because I start to be worried about the font. So we change it. I will add here 16. So every time we open a new one, it will open a bit bigger. All good now. Let's run it. So you need to click. You can run fully run here, or you can debug clicking on this option. Tap here. And it fails. So why it failed? Depends. Still some problem connecting to this machine, it seems so. I'm gonna stop here a second because I want to be sure what's happening. Don't waste time, and I come back in a second. Okay, all clear now. So that's a small note, a mistake I did. Here you must mark the run the script in context of the bundle. Okay, this is important because if not, it will not read all the Ruby files we have in the proper context. Okay, so having that, it should work now. Let's clean, because I did a run to be sure it was working. You can clean from here. Let's close it again. Let's close other tabs. So we only have opened, our file. Okay, all good. Let's run again. You tap here on debug. I need to stop it here on the first step. Okay, from the first step, you can, this is in fact going to another step. You can click here. And we can add another breakpoint here, and also here, here, and here, and continue the execution from here. Resume program. You can also click on step over, but let's do that because we added the breakpoint. This option, visit Capybara app host with the value in app host, that you can also check. Show value expression, sorry. This is the server where we will run. We will open the browser. Okay. So having already here, we will click on next, and it will open a browser. Okay. Let's just reduce the size of that. Yeah, move things around a bit. Gonna put that here. This other one here. So we can see both. Make it a bit bigger. And yeah, well, this you need to tap here. And access, you'll have this screen, this window with the access for to the page. Okay, so as you can see, the user and password is here, and you have other information from here, the Selenium WebDriver information of the action is doing. Okay, let's try to make it like that. Okay. We can even do like that. If we click to resume to the next step, it will fill the testing text field, and we click again, we'll do the other one. If you click again, it will tap on the sign in button and log in. Okay, now we are on the overview page. As you see, I'm on the system overview page of this SLE minion. To do that, first thing it will do is get the information from the system name. We now see that we have the system name of the minion. And on the next steps, it will go to the system page, follow the minion, and wait until I see some text on it. First thing it does is, in fact, reconnect, but using admin. So we'll just do that again. Yeah. And it will go, as you see, inside the minion. Okay. So inside the minion, the next step we do is the I should see this text. Okay. So we are now in this last step. And here, as you can see, clicking here, this is the text we want to have. You also have that we open a bit more here. Okay. This is the text. And we are on the uyuni product. This we can miss it. Yeah, we can skip it. So tap next, and now it will run this capybara method has content, and it will check if the SUSE Linux Enterprise Server 15 SP1 text is there. Okay, tap, and it is also there. So we have all the different steps completed, the scenario completed, the feature completed. If we tap on any of them, on the scenario, you will see all the different Selenium calls, requests, and posts that it did in case you want to debug something there. Okay? So that will be all. Yeah, just with that, you can play here, you can add other steps. Rerun again. Let's rerun completely without adding breakpoints. So you can see all the steps together. You can click here, and then it will do everything. Okay. So that's all. Thank you very much. Bye bye.